Veda took a lot out of me. I saw Hank's tweet earlier about the best weird things that have ever happened to him in that whole Twitter stream. This entire video is going to be as many best and weird things that have happened to me, that important fun combination. One summer, I came across a stream full of 4 largemouth bass with my dad, and we proceeded to build a dam of rocks, rescue them, and return them to the lake. I DJ'd my mom's high school reunion party because I know so much about the 80s music. Volunteered at NerdCon Nerdfighteria, and just so happened to talk to John Green about the Roads of Nerdfighteria. I got to do the meet and greet lottery, randomly got Josh Sundquist, and got to thank him for his submission to the project, in addition to getting his new book. My brother and I never had jazz choir all chorale together in high school, but it just so happens that my high school teacher, that we both had, but never together in class, now teaches choir at the college, local college, and now we get to go to night choir. My parents divorced and now are both happily remarried to someone else, which is awesome as well. And I never got to meet my grandfather, but he got into video recording so early that I literally know of him and about him through his Thoughts from Places videos of him traveling and just home videos of family. I got to become a 2-time state officer for New York FCCLA, so I got to go through the process twice, and I managed to haul my Mac to Syracuse 1 year to help run sessions and be a part of the creation of the conference. Ah, the call out of the blue in the fall to help out to the rescue. I felt like a superhero. The fact that I got to be a co-host of a kids' TV show for wellness because of a prompt to audition from my math teacher in high school. The 2005 Big Bass Attack year, in which the year before we just started doing video recording and we had caught, I think, 7 to 8 largemouth bass all over 20 inches in a span of about 2 to 3 weeks maybe, or just that year of 2005. And guess what? It's all on DVD. Definitely being involved in Tuataria and the creation of the puzzle solving and hunting for John's books, as well as editing together a bunch of people from around the world saying I love you for Esther Day. Supporting Mike Fozone's podcast, Welcome to Our Podcast, for so long that the slogan shoutouts dwarfed over time through different results to result in Everybody Polka. It's something that I didn't even come up with. Having over 1 terabyte of footage, of video game playing footage my brother and I record, of us playing things for the first time since about 2004. Getting wrapped into uploading high school choir concerts since 2008. Learning one of the biggest lessons of my life from a game called Bioshock Infinite called Constants and Variables. Having my Project for Awesome video in 2013 be featured in the middle of my college philosophy final. Celebrating New Year's 1 year with a bunch of people on a YouTube live stream all around the world, and then having a dance recess to conclude it. Learning about Esther Earle's story, reading This Star Won't Go Out, having her mom appreciate and watch my video, and then meeting Lori Earle in person to record her Nerdfighteria story at VidCon this year. Getting an actual waffle shipped to me in the mail for a donation I made to charity through the Harry Potter Alliance. I don't know, and I watched it get made on the live stream. Daily vlogging with a bunch of people from Project Chronicle for 1 year straight. Having a Six Flags adventure day trip with a friend on the same day that one of my parents got married. Just the ability to journal and use a DSLR in an airplane at 40,000 feet while also listening to Alan Watts lectures. Just flying, I guess. Of course, taking my first hike in the Adirondacks and bringing my DSLR the entire way, only dropping it once and capturing the adventure. Volunteering at VidCon 1 year and just so happening to get to shake Shay Carl's hand. Never meeting my mom's parents just a couple years ago, had a change of heart, actually had Christmas dinner with them. My mom just getting to better know them, and now everything is like awesome. Of course, the entire Road to Nerdfighteria journey on YouTube with because of Nerdfighteria and John and Hank, and currently the ability to lead it. This is a really strange one, but the fact that an Orb Weaver spider lived in my apartment for 3 to 4 months in between 2 bamboo stick plants. Spider never bit anybody. I got to watch it and take pictures of it, record it. It was weird. And then it just left. It was gone. It never came back. Having a painted turtle from the wild raised in my house and then releasing him into a friend's pond. That whole process. Knowing what it's like to adopt and take care of greyhounds. Catching a smallmouth on a boat while on a Google Hangout. Because of my involvement with New York FCCLA, becoming the photographer that gets to just take pictures of conferences and go to the banquet. Playing a disciple in the Last Supper at a local church and then singing in another church at which I don't belong to the congregation. I just like to sing. Yeah, I definitely can't remember everything that's important and fun to me, and it might not be weird. It might just be grateful and gratitude and entries from here. It seems like those awesome, weird, important, fun happenings in life, they never really come to an end. They're always sparsed everywhere. I'd love for this to become a YouTube tag, because this is just a fun topic. It's fun, just like that Twitter thread that Hank started. Felt the need to share that. Just felt good. What is important fun to you? What are some of the best weird things that you recall on, or maybe that you'll think about, you think, decades from now? If I've piqued your interest and you would like to continue to support me, helping me create best weird important fun things to me, you can check out my Patreon. Keeping you DFTBA, and I will see you next time. Everybody polka.